Today, I am sharing 6 Etsy shop ideas that can make you more money in your job that are actually more fun to create products for than certain other digital products. These are niches that I've personally had success in, having created a 7-figure digital product shop and other 6-figure physical product shops. So these are in niches that are performing very well in the market right now, so well that you can make thousands of dollars a month in profit if done correctly. These 6 shop ideas include many niches and interests and are all powered by AI, so design experience is not really a necessity, and there is something here for everyone if you tend to lean more on the creative side of things and get bored trying to create things like checklists or printable calendars like I do. The first Etsy shop idea is selling PNG files for sublimation crafters. Now, if you are unfamiliar with sublimation crafting, this may sound a little bit weird, but it is extremely popular. Sublimation crafting is a digital printing technique where crafters use heat to transfer dye or ink onto various surfaces like metal, plastic, and fabric. And many of these crafters look for designs, the PNG files, online, and then mass produce custom tumblers, t-shirts, mugs, promotional products, personalized gifts, mouse pads, and phone cases, just to name a few. As the Etsy seller, you would list the PNG files, and then the crafter would purchase them, download them, and then use them on whatever they want. This is an excellent digital product shop because you can create PNG files for practically any niche, job, hobby, or interest, essentially never running out of design ideas. You can take Bailey Designed Co., my shop, for example, and over the past 2 years, I've been able to sell over $1 million from an on average price point of $3 for things like these tumbler wraps and t-shirt designs. Start by selecting an AI image generation tool like Midjourney or My Designs, which has several AI image generation options to choose from. And for me today, I usually choose My Designs and the access to Ideogram from within there, or even Kittle due to the specific results that they give. However, I also experiment with what I would get from DALL-E 3 as well as Midjourney, since I am providing my Design Club members with the results from all 4 AI tools to help them choose which would sell best for them in their shops, so they don't have to end up using all of their credits testing new styles, which I know something is all that we hate doing. I do recommend using an Etsy keyword and research tool like eRank or Everbee to complete research on what people are actually searching for. You do want to find a happy medium behind substantial search volume, but still low competition, especially when your store is just starting out, so that you have a chance to show up in search results. From there, create and list your digital product, but you don't have to worry about shipping anything. So this is a great way to start building mostly passive income over time. Now, for this second shop idea, I have mentioned it before in other videos, but if I were launching a new Etsy shop in 2024, I would choose what is known as the hybrid shop method. And this shop provides the best of both worlds by selling print on demand, otherwise known as POD, as well as digital products. One of the downfalls of selling print on demand products is that you're stuck waiting for funds to be available. And while this isn't a huge problem once you're more established, it is really rough as a new shop owner. And having digital products allows you to make money and receive it more quickly so that your cash flow is more consistent. So how do you create a successful hybrid shop? The answer here is to really hone in on a highly specific target market. For example, if your demographic is teachers, specifically elementary school and middle school teachers, you could sell print-on-demand t-shirts and mugs that appeal to this demographic while also listing relevant digital products, such as things like personalized phone wallpapers with funny teacher sayings, or maybe teacher quotes, or teacher-inspired greeting cards, think like a funny teacher birthday card that they can send to their colleagues, or even things like teacher wall art, and then things like printable class schedules, chore charts, and planners. This hybrid setup works really well because a teacher may come across your funny t-shirts or mugs and click add to cart, And then they also see that your shop sells funny greeting cards for teachers and then maybe student star charts. It is a really natural way to get an upsell, making this a fantastic Etsy shop that can really bring in thousands of dollars a month. You can use your AI image generation tool of choice for this specific Etsy shop, making it a really easy way to get started. You may or may not have heard of this third option before, but the third idea is to sell digital files for junk journals or scrapbookers. Junk journals are an exciting way for people to express their artistic flair, combining vintage aesthetics with modern creativity. So these digital files typically include printable pages, embellishments, and decorative elements that the buyers can use to craft their personalized journals. Perfect for scrapbooking, memory keeping, or simply as a creative outlet, junk journals cater to a wide audience looking for unique and customizable products. By offering these digital files on Etsy, you can tap into a thriving community of crafters and journal enthusiasts that are eager to bring their visions to life. Again, with AI tools out there like Midjourney, Kittle, and My Designs, it is super easy to create these creative digital files. Do let me know down in the comments if you knew junk journaling was a digital product thing or not, because I am really curious to see if this is something that's been on your radar as something that is very highly profitable on Etsy right now in the digital product space. Next, we have an SVG file shop. So SVG files are a type of file that crafters use with a special electronic cutting machine like a Cricut. Basically, the Cricut takes the work out of cutting designs by hand or like the X-Acto knife with much more precision that most of us can't handle. Once cut out, the crafter can use the design on just about anything, from pasting it into a scrapbook, a junk journal, a planner, or anything with a paper base, to even creating like iron-on decals for clothing and other types of fabric. Like creating PNG files, you'll want to select a design program and make your own or use AI to design a unique SVG file. And unlike PNG files, you can stick with text-based designs or more simple designs for an easier approach. This is a fully digital Etsy shop, so it's another fantastic way to build some mostly passive income with your time. As your shop inventory expands, I recommend creating large bundles of your most popular designs or even designs within the same niche. These are really popular on Etsy and are a great way to earn more per sale. You'll also want to pay attention to new trends, new styles, and popular quotes that aren't copyrighted, of course, and themes like, for example, cottagecore. And these are just really great ways to put your shop on people's radar faster. Number five is wall art. And wall art is still a staple on Etsy and for good reason. Everybody has their own unique style for their living space and many love switching out their wall art for different seasons, themes, or holidays. You can totally focus on a specific niche like wall art for yoga studios or fitness lovers, or hone in on a particular art style like typography illustrations or photographs or minimalist designs. After you decide on the niche, work on creating beautiful wall art prints. And again, don't worry if you're not an artist, I'm not one either. You can totally use AI or a user-friendly program like Canva to design beautiful art. Then list the wall art in various sizes and offer multiple framing options if you choose to sell physical prints through a POD provider. My last Etsy shop idea is selling stickers. These can either be sold as printable stickers, so a PNG file for the customer to print and use at home with their own sticker machine or maker, or you can use a print-on-demand supplier like Printify to print and ship the stickers for you. This really is a popular bread and butter niche in the Etsy marketplace, and it is for good reason. Despite the digital age that we're in, stickers are still really beloved. Whether we're talking about journalers, teachers, crafters, or businesses wanting promotional stickers to hand out, or kids like my daughter that need to put 25 different stickers on everything that they own, stickers are not going away. Like many of the ideas on this list, you could choose a practically infinite number of niches for stickers. You can create custom sticker designs for businesses. You could specialize in bridal stickers, stickers for classrooms, or stickers for bullet journal fanatics. I also recommend considering what kind of stickers do you want to sell. Die cut, vinyl, and repositionable stickers are all some of the most popular types, but consider the material and features when thinking about your audience and how you're creating them. An AI tool like Kittle or Ideogram is going to be your best bet when designing for stickers due to that specific sticker style that they can create for. Regardless of what niche appeals to you, research trends first using Everbee or E-Rank. Then explore what products within that niche are receiving good search volume but have less competition. That's where you want to focus to get your sales coming in, and then repeat the process by continuing to focus on creating more of what's selling in your shop. I recommend checking out this video next if you want to take a look at 5 of my personal AI income streams for more ideas on what's working right now. And as always, thanks so much for watching.